Welcome back to Serious Journalism with Beza!
Yeah, welcome back. Welcome back, folks. That was Jerry Doucette and his band Doucette doing Mama Let Him Play. Some rock and roll. He wants to play some rock and roll, Mama. Let him play. Yeah. Anyway, you're listening to Serious Journalism. My name is Basamp. I am the host of this program. We are starting the second half of our show. We're going to 1 a.m., folks. So strap on. Strap on your listening shoes and, I don't know, dance around in your living room or speed around in your car, I guess. I don't know. I don't know how you're listening to this. You could share if you'd like. You can go to my Serious Journalism Facebook page and just, you know, like leave a comment under that first post. Just be like, hey, by the way, when I listen to your program, I am, you know, I'm at work doing my late night delivery rounds. I don't know. That's a thing. I used to be a courier back in the day, so that's, I know that there are people out there who are just starting work at this hour, and they're driving around the city, dropping off whatever, I don't know, packages, and I don't know, donuts maybe? I don't know what they're delivering. But, yeah, you know, folks are driving around, listening to the radio. I know that's a thing. So if you're, like, driving around, let me know. If you're, like, lying on your bathroom floor eating Hot Pockets, let me know. If you're, you know, hollering at squirrels in your backyard, like Randy, you know, let me know. I'm curious. Maybe you're, like, lying in bed and, like, you use this program to, like, put you to sleep. It works if you're a maniac. If you're a maniac, this is the kind of thing that'll just, like, put you right to sleep, you know? Like, if you grew up in a traumatic household, you know? You're like, I can't sleep unless there's, like, you know, five people yelling in the next room. Then, I get it, dude. Totally get it. Anyway. Speaking of whatever I was speaking of, let's go over to, let's check in with Ant. Let's get Ant in here. And, yeah, let's get Ant in here and let's see what his, review is about this week. I'm sure it's probably something, you know, informative and important. Ant Sparrow, by the way. Ant Sparrow. He does Ant Reviews things. You find him on the internet somewhere. Check it out. It's a very important show. He's doing a very important work over there. So without further ado, let me toss it over to my pal, Ant Sparrow. Ant, take it away. Ant.
Hey.
Yeah.
Thanks, Basamp. And welcome to Ant Reviews Things. Today, I think I am reviewing zombies. You know, like the undead. It's all over the place. Basamp.
What?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Me too. First off, if there was a zombie invasion, I hope we get those slow-moving zombies. Like the ones in the movie Night of the Living Dead.
Yeah.
I don't want to deal with those zombies that can run fast. I would rather deal with the slow-moving zombies, because it'd be like an elderly person chasing you. I could handle that. Those zombies that run, though, man, they ain't cool. If there were running zombies in a zombie invasion, I would get bit really quick. And then I would turn into a zombie. But I wouldn't run. I would walk at a pace that is comfortable to me. I'm stubborn like that. Also, Basamp.
What?
I'm basing all of this from years of watching zombie movies. I've done my research. Oh, man. Dolores O'Riordan. The girl from the band The Cranberries is rolling over in their grave.
O'Riordan.
Too soon? Sorry about that. Sorry I had to let it linger. Hey, there are so many different rules when it comes to zombie invasion. Too many to name. Basamp!
What?
What would be your weapon of choice in a zombie apocalypse?
My weapon of choice? Ew, I don't know.
Wrong answer! If it's the slow-moving zombies, I would just trip them or tie their shoelaces together. I also think I can survive a zombie apocalypse because I have seen the movie Home Alone so many times. So, the original Night of Living Dead and Dawn of the Dead movies are so good. I stopped watching that popular cable TV show about zombies that walk. I read all the issues of the comic book that the show was based on, and the show didn't compare to the comic books. Sorry, I'm just going on a little rant here.
That's fine.
But I think the worst part of the zombie invasion or zombie apocalypse would be the smell. God, it's got to smell horrible. And Basamp.
What?
Remember.
Okay.
Do you know where the safest place is to be during a zombie invasion?
No.
It's the living room. Back to you, Basamp.
Oh. Hey, it's Sparkle, everyone. Ant reviews things. Check them out where fine reviews are not present. My weapon of choice in a zombie apocalypse. Man, I don't know. A blunt object, probably. No. You know what my weapon of choice would be? A chain link fence. I feel like chain link fences do a pretty good job at keeping zombies at bay. Yes. A chain link fence. And it will be guarded by a tiny cowboy. I know what you're thinking. You're like, Basamp, keep talking about tiny cowboys. This is awesome. But, no.
Like and subscribe to Ant Reviews Things.